right. So the next one also is a product-related, you know, presentation before we start with the panel. And this is about technological innovations in bedded units. And the speaker is Mr. Ashok Ambhore from Draeger, India. So Ashok has been actually in field of sales throughout his career. He's a strategist and multicultural experience of 20 years in healthcare spectrum, comprising medical devices and hospital consumables, diagnostics, devices and pharmaceuticals. Currently works as the sales manager with India in for India and Peninsula countries for Draeger. As experienced professional with proven track record of working in areas of diabetes and cardiovascular management and anesthesia and operating room, he's going to talk to us today about bedded panels. Can I call Ashok, you know, on stage, please?
Good morning. Yeah, good morning, one and all. At the outset, let me thank the organizer for giving us this platform to talk about the technological innovations in the bedded units. My name is Ashok Ambhore, and I work with the capacity of sales manager for Draeger India, as well as Peninsula countries. Just a 5-point agenda. Very quickly, I'll run you through about the technological competences of Draeger India, and of course, Draeger as an organization. And the challenges as far as the bedded units are concerned, the customer insights in terms of the advisories, as well as, you know, bedded units for the patient safety. We'll talk about some regulatory standards in India as well as in the international market, and give you a quick overview about what Prana is all about. Prana is a brand name of this bedded unit, which is recently out of Draeger India manufacturing facility. And of course, we'll conclude it with some remarks. A quick introduction of Draeger. It's a global giant at a leadership position in technology devices like anesthesia as well as ventilators. And we operate out of 6 major therapeutic areas. Monitoring and IT from value segment to the premium one, the complete healthcare IT setup. Infrastructure projects, we have a leadership position in the pendants category. We do have, you know, several types of pendants, whether it is motorized, single arm, double arm, etc., etc. And then we have the complete solutions for the hospital consumables as well as services. We are again at a leadership position in the anesthesiology with a different devices starting from value segment to premium one, and of course at respiratory care as well. And this is a classical example of, you know, the technological leadership at respiratory care, because recently we launched one device called Palma Vista, wherein you can see the actual, you know, lungs inflating and deflating, and you can see the alveoli being recruited. So that's a real technology for leadership. And then of course we have service product. It's been almost 2.5 years we have been working on this product. When we look at the current bedded unit market or the supply unit markets, you know, all these days we have been dependent on, you know, buying it from Germany, and then by the time it comes here in India, it's very expensive. And then, you know, we are operating out of a market where, you know, you have a lot of challenges of convincing a customer as far as standards are concerned. So finally we made it for you. And it is not just for India, but also for the world market. As I said, we have been working since last almost 2.5 years. You know, we extensively researched the market, and we tried to understand what kind of trends are taking in place as far as this supply unit market is concerned. We hired a very reputed market research agencies, and, you know, we found out, you know, some of the very peculiar observations, not only from the customer point of view, but also the users, as well as the hospital planners and architects, as well as the MGPS contractors, who are very key and, you know, dominating this category. Some of the observations which we found are, you know, like, for example, the bedded panels. Now, if you look at any projects, you know, most of the money goes, you know, in buying, you know, the critical care devices as well as MRI or so on and so forth. So by the time, you know, some amount of money is left, and then you think of furniture, the hospital furniture. And therefore, when you look at bedded panel, or rather when customer looks at bedded panel, it is always perceived as if, you know, just of aesthetic value. And day in and day out, the regulations or the standards which are required to follow as far as bedded and supply units are concerned, you know, they are violated. So here, you know, it is just an aesthetic value. I will show you some of the hilarious experience which, you know, I have experienced in the couple of months before, since we are in this, you know, we started doing this research. The other thing is the MJPS contractor. Now, MJPS contractor in this category is a very key person. Now, what happens is, you know, when you have a hospital owner, you know, who will give you a call, who will give him a call, you know, in the middle of the night and would say that, you know, I have an issue with this outlet, this is leaking, can you please help me out? So he is the person who is based out locally. He comes, he fixes the problem, sometimes doesn't fix the problem, maybe he fixes it day after tomorrow or tomorrow, I mean, it takes some time. But the point here is that, you know, because of that service providing attitude, you know, there is a solid bond between the hospital owners and those MJPS contractors. And then whenever, you know, hospital requires any bedded panel, he is the one, you know, who provides them. Now, you are providing a product to a hospital, you know, and then, you know, just because they need a product, you are providing a kind of a box. You do not know the clinical insight about it. You do not know the significance of, you know, what happens when the very critical, you know, critically ill patient is treated on the bedhead and, you know, he's on a ventilator. So, you know, at that point in time, actually, the regulatory standards get violated. The another thing is that many times what happens, you know, just to fulfill the need of a customer, you know, and he doesn't do it intentionally. You know, he doesn't have intention to, you know, fool the customer. He just do it out of the need of the customer and then fulfill his need. And sometimes what he does is that, you know, he actually, you know, reverse engineer the most popular brand in the market and then, you know, and offer it to the customer. So that's how some of the very interesting, you know, observations we got as far as the research is concerned. Now, these are some of the real-time observations which I have been observing since last maybe 6 months. When you know, our team, we were talking to some of the people, some of the hospital concern authorities, you know, people said it is just a metal box, you know, which provides the basic services which are required at the bedside. So that's the comment from one of the purchase head and MJPS contractor. Why should I spend on this? You know, I spoke to one of my doctor and one of my friend doctor, and he said, you know, you don't need to spend much on bedhead panel. You know, it is just a metal box which provides services, like which provide gases to the patients. This is a comment which is coming from one of the very big business house in Maharashtra, and, you know, who is opening the hospital. Of course, there are some who knows what quality is all about, who knows what standards are all about, and they end up buying our product, and they said, yes, Draeger imported bedhead panels are great quality, and, you know, they are really sturdy, and they look really great. One comment I'll share with you, which I just got a query the other day from one of the biomedical engineer turned entrepreneur who started consulting. And he sent me this image. And he said, can you please help me that how can I fix medical gas outlet on this panel? Now this panel, this bedded unit is a wooden structure. This is not a panel. And if you look at the image here, you know, there are some wires which are open, and he is intent to place a medical gas outlet. You know, a very critical component like oxygen is flowing through, and then you have critical right beside. And then, you know, in case of some adverse events, that point in time, you know, we realize that, you know, we should not have compromise on this. One very interesting comment about one of the, you know, hospital planners yesterday when I was talking to her on a Draeger booth. She said, can you please explain me about what this EMI or ISO 00097 is all about? She was very intelligent. She knew. She had an experience. She said, you know, couple of months back, you know, I have suggested my client to go for the wooden bedded panel. And then, you know, it end up, you know, catching a fire. And, you know, it was kind of very discouraging for me because, you know, I was consulting them. And then I realized that, you know, before I advise to people, I need to know the standards. And therefore, such kind of adverse events are not repeated. A very encouraging comment. The other comment which you know, we are working on a very large project of almost 7,500 crore hospital. And in that hospital, you know, there is this project manager, you know, who is suggesting to the hospital that, why don't you buy Korean? You know, it looks very good. It has got a great aesthetic value. So that's the comment. These are the real-time comments. The point which I'm trying to say here is that when you make a bedded panel, when you procure a bedded panel, you need to consider all the regulatory standards which are required so that, you know, any unforeseen event can be, prevented. Taking a chance, at Draeger we don't take chance, but, having an adverse event is just a matter of chance. You know, this is one of the very reputed hospital in Andhra Pradesh, and it's a chain of hospital. And look at what they have done. This is again a wooden bedded panel, and they have an issue with this oxygen medical gas outlet. They want to fix it, and they are asking us how can we do it. So these are some of the very hilarious comments as far as the bedded panel uses are concerned. Now, when we looked at this market, as I said, we did extensive research. We found out that there are not many companies operating in this category who really talk about standards. I am not saying quality. Who talk about standards, who adhere to the regulations and the standards which are required for the supply units. And when we looked at this market, we realized that probably this is a good opportunity for us, to add a value to the market and make hospitals and patients safe. And therefore, we decided to kick off this project of Make in India. The whole objective here is to provide a safe and enduring workflow solutions with the help of German technology and of course the Indian manufacturing skills. We have, a very skilled labor. The bedded panel which is manufactured in Germany would cost maybe 1.5 lakh. But we knew, and rather, with the help of our research, we concluded that this can be possible to make it just at a half cost. And we are successful enough to reduce the cost by almost 50% to 60%. And therefore, we are here in this market. And the purpose is very clear. Provide a quality product which adhere to the standards or the regulatory requirement at a very affordable cost. So that's the goal here. Now let's have a look at some of the regulatory standards, what are required when it comes to the bedded panel or the supply unit market. There are couple of prerequisites before you go for the European conformity or the medical device directive, compliance. You need to have at least an EMC test to be done. Now, what is EMC test? Now, you just imagine in the ward or in the ICU, the patient is on the ventilator, he is lying on the bed, and the monitor is there to measure his core parameters. And because of EMI and EMC, since the electrical presence is there, it has got a capability to influence the output of a ventilator, the tidal volume. Now, just to take an example, even if you get a phone call, what happens is that, because of that phone call, the screen on the monitor is slightly shaken up. It is nothing but an electrical magnetic interference. So we at Draeger ensure that the bedded panel which is out of the out given to the customer, it is thoroughly tested and it complies to the EMI and EMC test. The another thing is the oxygen enrichment test. Now we must have heard, or rather it's quite very often happen that some kind of a fire incidents happens in hospital. And if at all, if it's a bedded unit which is made up of wooden, then you are running at a very high risk. So oxygen enrichment test is something which is prescribed in the ISO 11197, which says that at any point in time there should not be oxygen concentration of 25% in the bedded panel. So that is a test what we do and we comply to it. Trust me, I was talking to a couple of people here around the across the H.P.I conference, and when I happened to talk to one of the marketing head of a good company who markets bedded panels, they were not aware of this. Not many people are aware of this, that you have to comply to the EMI EMC standard or even oxygen enrichment test. If you look at the Draeger panel, the oxidized gas and the nearest exposed electricals, there should be a distance that is prescribed in the standard. We at Draeger follow those standards very strictly. There should be a distance of at least 0.2 meter. Some of the other standards are like the heart of the bedded panel, that is the medical gas outlet. Now, medical gas outlet is something, through which you provide services. The patient is inhaling the oxygen with the help of ventilator, and that goes inside his lung to the last point, that is alveoli. So this is actually invasive. According to the medical device directive, it falls into the medical device category. It is not just a box. You just need to understand, or rather, while consulting the people, we need to understand that it is not just a metal box. You have to understand that the oxygen and the electricals flow through the same breath. you are running at a very high risk, and therefore you need to adhere to those standards. As far as, again, the electric, the medical gas outlet is concerned, it should comply to the ISO 9170. Now, when you look at the ISO 9170, it's almost, you know, 150-page document. So there are certain things which are prescribed that this is how an ideal terminal unit should be. Say, for example, the connection and disconnection test, what we do at Draeger. Normally, what happens is that, you know, people end up buying, you know, because of lack of awareness, those very economical products as far as the TU is concerned or the terminal unit is concerned. So every day and night, every day, the leakage happens. Nobody is even aware of it. Now, what happens is this, you know, at the end of the month when your purchase manager of the hospital signs a lot of bills, that why are we consuming so much of gases? But he is not aware that that gas is getting leaked. So the ISO 9170 prescribe, or they say that, you know, your outlet or the medical gas outlet should be leak proof. I'll tell you one incidence. When we were making this outlet, you know, there is a component inside which is called as O-ring. There are two O-rings. When we try to procure that O-ring in India, you know, unfortunately, we spoke to many suppliers because we wanted to cut the cost, but we could not get that quality what Draeger Germany gives us. And ultimately, we end up buying that O-ring from Germany. So that's the kind of impact which it makes, because outlet at the end of the day is the heart of the bedded panel, and it needs to be leak-proof. Otherwise, then there's no point in having, you know, you can have, even without bedded panel, services to be provided at the customer bedside. Biocompatibility test. All material what is used in the TU or the medical gas outlet is biocompatible. It is ROHS compliant. You know, we buy raw material from one of the biggest organizations in the world like BASF. They are known for it, the biggest chemical company, with good quality plastics. Another thing is, as far as safety part is concerned, the ingress protection test. Now, if you look at the structure of the bedded panel which is mounted there in at our booth, and I request you to please have a look at it. At any point in time, neither the bystander or the end users cannot access the electricals from outside. It is tested even for the touch current. At any point in time, you cannot have a shock. That's very critical. So as far as safety is concerned, we have taken all those corrective measures in those. This is how it looks like. It's a completely customizable product. It's available in both the forms, single duct as well as double duct. You can configure the number of outlets what you want as per the requirement at the ICU or ward, the number of data cables, the number of telephones, the number of electricals, the medical rail, 300 mm or 600 mm, you know, everything is configurable, and there are four standard colors, and even if you want a color out of, you know, of your choice, that also can be configured, but that should be from the RAL category only. This is what I just explained, how you configure. You require length, duct, medical rail, reading light. As far as ward is concerned, you can have a reading light, you can have direct light or indirect light, and so on and so forth. And we also provide a nurse call cutout. So this is about standards. Now, what do we do in Draeger Prana? Now, if you look at this slide, the left side, you know, will give you an overview about the aesthetic part, and the right side will give you about the actual standard adherence, what we do in Draeger Prana. We have a structure of 7 robust aluminum profile. The moment I say 7 robust aluminum profile, which means its weight is around 15 to 18 kgs. And all those manufacturers which are available today in India have a weight of almost just 5 to 6 kgs, not more than 10 kgs. The point which I'm trying to convey here is that, you know, it will last long. It is tested for 20 years of life. So the kind of value which we are trying to deliver to the customer at an affordable cost is humongous. The powder coating thickness, there is a prescribed standard for this as well, because powder coating thickness and the anti-corrosion, you know, it goes hand in hand. Although it's aluminum profile, but because of the usage profile in the hospital, you know, you need to maintain that standard of having a micron size of 50 to 70 mm. Profile thickness is almost 1.1 to 1.85 mm. It's smooth surface, there are no edges, which is very safe. Medical rail, as I said, 300, 600 mm. Powder coating test we have done. Now, what is powder coating test? Probably, you know, we would be the only company who does this. We do the powder coating, this powder coating test for almost 1,000 hours with the help of salt spray. And then with the help of that, you know, we can predict the life of the profile. they predict the life of the bedded panel, and then hence there is no corrosion as well. All the fasteners which are available in bedded panel Prana are stainless steel. So there is no chance of having any, you know, corrosion issue. But this is all about aesthetic part. The most critical part of bedded panel is this. The impact test, which is done with the help of, you know, 8 to 10 kg weight, which is thrown on the profile, and the sturdiness is, you know, gauge. EMI-EMC test, leakage test part as far as the terminal units are concerned, touch current test, the oxygen enrichment test, the ingress protection test, and we adhere to the electrical standards of ISA 60884. Just to share with you, these are some of the test setup what we do at Draeger. We have a manufacturing facility just 45 minutes away from this place in Vasai. We started our manufacturing with the help of three products. Started with the medical gas terminal units, that is DIN standard as well as British standard. The DIN standard is currently available for the sale. The British would be available by the end of this month. Bedded panel is ready, and the rigid pendant would come, you know, maybe in the first quarter. So these are some of the test setup. You can see very clearly there is a distinction between the dedicated profile for the gases and the dedicated profile for the electricals, which is there in the double duct, which offers you a safety. As I said, the terminal unit is an heart of a bedded panel. It is not about just the disconnection and connection test, but there are five important tests what we do in bedded panel for the terminal units. You know, like the test for endurance, the pressure drop test. Just to give you an example, the connection and disconnection test, what exactly we do? We insert a probe into the TU for 10,000 times. And we do it 10 times in 1 minute. After doing such an extensive disconnection and connection test, we send that TU for the leakage test. And after that, if it is leak, that is rejected. And that's the reason, you know, there are a couple of credentials which I would like to share with you, that since last 15 years, you know, there are this medical gas outlet, you know, which are mounted at Jayadeva, Bangalore. Nothing has happened as of now. The outlet which are manufactured in India would be bought by Germany. Eventually, you know, it's made in India and made for the world. And we are very happy that, you know, we are very successful in reducing that cost. Just to share with you again, that within a span of just 15 days, we have had around, you know, 3,000 order entries of the medical gas outlet. They're very popular. This is a video which will give you an overview about, it's a just 3 minute video, 30 seconds video. Give you an overview about what is connection and disconnection test. Now, if you can see, this is a terminal unit, and then it is. Where is my thing? I'm sorry, the link is not there. I forgot to give the link to him. But what happens here is that the probe goes inside, comes out, goes inside, comes out. You know, that test for the O-ring capability of having a leakage as well as the endurance test. It is just a 30-second video. But the way I explained is exactly the same what is there in the video. The another very important thing is your facility of manufacturing facility. Our facility of manufacturing, which is in Vasai, is certified by TÜV SÜD. One of the most prominent total quality management organization. We have had an audit here. They inspected our processes. They had interviewed with us. And we are certified for this. Now, another interesting thing is the CE certification. Now, if you roam around, you will find that there are many players, they claim that they are CE certified. But as an architect or a planner, or even as a biomedical engineer, or even as a doctor, you need to know the difference between the CE. CE today, you know, can be self-certified, which is available at maybe, you know, 10,000 or 15,000. You can self-certify yourself for the European confirmatory. And if it is falling into class 1B, you don't require it at all because it is self-certification. But when it comes to, as per the medical device directive and the European confirmatory, if your products falls into the category of class 2B, you have to have this audit to be done by the total quality management authorities. Because when you say medical device and total medical device directive, it is invasive. The air is going inside your lung till alveoli, and the patient is breathing. It's a medical device that needs to be certified as per the standard of class 2B. Draeger, all supply units falls into the same category. This is an CE certification for us, for the medical gases. And to conclude the case for the technological innovation, the kind of technology what we have you know, implemented in bedded panel and the terminal units. There are two very important things, you know, which comes out as a conclusion. If we have to ensure the hospital safety, if we have to ensure the patient safety, if we have to prevent those, you know, unforeseen events of fire, if we are proactive in while advising the patients at the hospital architects and planner phase, because hospital architects and planner are the people or the key categories of the people who are involved in the projects right from the day one. The marketing companies or the healthcare organizations comes at a much later stage when they want to sell a device. So when you are advising to your patients, it is very critical to make the customer understand that whatever you are buying should be as per the standard, should be as per the medical device directive. It should comply the local regulatory, you know, requirement. Whether customer has a budget or he doesn't have a budget, that is absolutely his call. Whether he want to buy or not buy, absolutely his call. But he should be made aware. And as a community of hospital planners and architects, you know, we can play a very important role here by making hospital and patient safe. The another thing is the healthcare organization level. Now, when we come into picture at a very later stage, but we also should be, you know, responsibly manufacturing, you know, those kind of products which and follow those standards which are required for that particular category. So if we implement this, probably a day is not far, then, you know, both of us can ride this glory of the booming healthcare industry in India. Thank you very much. Any questions? I'm open for the questions. Yes, sir. Sir, you're not audible.
You just mentioned regarding the medical gases. Do you use the AVSUs, sort of specific sort of area or sort of department valves which are given on the medical gas pipeline? Do you use those in the installation of the medical gas pipework?
Now, what do we use those installations, sir?
Because what will that sort of do is basically for the difference between a general ward and a sort of an intensive care ward, Draeger bedded trunking can be in sort of both the wards, but in sort of intensive care ward, there are sort of duplicate gases, therefore you'll have some sort of area wall segregation. Do you use that here?
Area wall segregations. We have area control unit out of the ICU, so the gases can be controlled from there. So that comes as a part of medical gas management. So we have area control unit outside OR as well as ICU. So they are there. So that can be segregated. And I assume that you are asking this question with context of service.
Yes, sir.
Right? So that is possible. That can be done.
And the second question what I want to ask you is about, other than the bedded trunking, would Draeger be doing in India the Draeger pendants, the pendants which come down from ceiling?
Verticals.
Would that be the next step?
Exactly. See, when we started manufacturing in India, you know, our management has very successfully convinced the Draeger Germany, because when you look at the Indian market and the competences in the healthcare category, there are not many companies. So the way Europe or US looks at us, you know, is different. They just look at it that it's a very potential market. But when it comes to technical skills, you know, they have their own views. But we are very successful in convincing Germany. And as I said, you know, at a very first go, when the TU was sent to Germany, that this is made in India, it was passed. And they were surprised that at such a cost, we can deliver such a high quality product. So keeping that momentum, you know, in continuation, probably tomorrow we would manufacture a very critical care device like anesthesia or ventilator here, and we may do so. Thank you very much.
So So can I request you guys to come, you know, one row ahead.